Having a lovely, positive time with each other. Kind of looks wholesome, joyful, pleasure. A lot of people just enjoying themselves. If you chuck yourself wholeheartedly into something, sooner or later you find out who you are, because you get everything about you reflected back. Now, I want people to come together and commit themselves to doing something together. Yeah, I've said it before, to the extent in which, like, there's practically no way out. The only way out is to come to terms with who you are and then say, oh, I'm responsible for that. I better start doing something about that. And to try and to fail. And then to try harder and fail harder, you know? That is, I really value that about this situation. And it's still working for me.
So working together is such a positive, strong experience for lots of people. The harmony that's created when people work together in a safe and loving space. Under pressure, but sort of somehow positive pressure, you know, with precepts in mind. So it's always held within a very positive space. And that has fed me, has made me realize what I have to offer. All my growing up, if you like, all my real unfolding, becoming who I am, has been through doing this. I think the festival has been an annual sort of marking of that each year, in a way, of growing in confidence and more and more faith, more and more faith in the Dharma, more and more ability to experience the joy.
I love how experimental it is. People seem very friendly, very colourful, always willing to help out. People feel quite overwhelmed by it, actually, sometimes. Yeah. It's like people are living up to their ideals here, which is really beautiful to see. Such amazing people all coming together and sharing, creating a space together, which I find magical. It's magical, that's what it would be.
Initially, it was people who had a very strong ethical passion involved in social action, meeting Buddhism, and that was very much Lokabandhu's plan. And then the festival has just taken off since then, grown and grown and grown, from sort of 200 to 3,000 people.
It's been just an exploration of people coming in, kind of finding a place, finding plenty of opportunity for them to offer and give and create, and then they're accepted, really, and then they've kind of make it their own home. I think an awful lot of people find Buddhafield a very accepting place of them, of who they are. Now, of course, you know, I've got in mind, Bhante says, well, don't accept yourself, which I agree with too, but there's something about a need for people first to accept themselves, whatever they are, whoever they are, and then, with love, to start challenging themselves. For me, I think, and I'm confident it's the case for a lot of other people, you know, you start with your social sort of relations with other people. I think Buddhafield has just said, we love you, and there's a place for you here. And I just think a lot of people need that. I certainly needed that. Amen.
the kindness starts with you. Turn full circle when it's you. And the flame warm burn with love and hold us now.
Obviously though, the spiritual life goes a lot further beyond that. People come along to a festival and they kind of think it's just like any other festival, you know, whatever they've done at other festivals, whatever rules there have been in their notion of a community, those are kind of what people assume it is. And there's a thing where, it's the other edge of it, isn't it, in terms of being very accepting, Buddhafield hasn't gone, it hasn't been very authoritarian, it hasn't done an awful lot of boundary holding around saying, well, but this is what spiritual practice is and consists of. No, I don't want people to take that too literally, because I think there's been lots of effort to communicate within Buddhafield, but it just needs more and more of that. The Dharma has got something to say about kind of which way is up, and you know, what are positive states of mind, and what are negative ones, and what conduces to a more contented, loving state of mind, and what doesn't.
And then maybe they see sometimes it's not perfect. And they get disappointed. But
Buddhafield Festival has been such a wonderful experience for us. It's very lively, full of life, people are friendly.
Although there are so many tents and so many people here, but I still felt really calm and peaceful here. Mm-hmm. That's really wonderful.
Yes.
I find this place a place to express yourself, be yourself. People express themselves in many different ways. You can go with your clothes on or you can go without it.
It is like the feeling you get at the end of a retreat when everybody looks beautiful, you trust everybody's open heart. And it's like that, but with singing and dancing and joyfulness all thrown in. I've just had a wonderful dancing session at the end of that ritual with my chapter. And we were just all looking at each other and saying, wow, what a great chapter, and enjoying that sense of being order members together, feeling really full of love and being able to express it in a joyful sort of way.
It's always the right time to start working on friendship and relationship. And just one needs to do that in the good times, probably especially the good times, and in the bad times, you know, because sooner or later one's going to need that. Some being in the future will need the friendship that you can develop right now and the connection you can develop right now. You might need it, other beings might need it.